Amen. God bless you and welcome to our Thursday morning here devotional. And as we continue on the suffering servant, I want to share something with you that Isaiah continues. Again, the descriptions from Friday of last week to our last two on Monday and Tuesday continue to explain how the Lord was born into something to be great and yet had to endure and suffer the things that we caused. And Isaiah 53:12 is no different. It says, "I will give him the honors of a victorious soldier because he exposed himself to death. He was counted among the rebels. He bore the sins of many and interceded for rebels." This is a picture of the suffering servant as, you know, kind of directed thoughts of Jesus himself. And today's, you know, the passage portrays Jesus almost like an attorney pleading our case before God and the judge. And it points toward the victory that Jesus experiences today in our lives because he fulfilled that sacrifice that was needed according to the Jewish law. And now for centuries, it continues to continue to redeem people. It has not lost its power, that redemption blood. And so, you know, when I tell you the word transgressors, what comes to mind? Some people would say criminals, thieves, prostitutes, drug addicts. People will think about people that are just wrong in life and they're full of sin, who are addicted to doing the wrong, and because they continue to do it, they can't help themselves from continuing to do it. But I think, can we put ourselves in the same context? I mean, I don't know that we would ever, I hope we would never separate ourselves from somebody that we would label with a name, because sin is sin, wrong is wrong, and the Lord came to redeem that. And how do I know that? Because he counted himself as part of us, even though he had no reason to, folks. He counted himself to be human so that he could come to bear the sins of this world. And here we have a sinless Savior coming to take on suffering for you and I. And, you know, he could have condemned us, left us to our sin. And, you know, we could have tried all that we could, but we would have never been able to find ourselves in the place to ever find ourselves to be redeemed. And why is that? Because there's darkness in our hearts. Ultimately, there are things within our hearts that reveal in time, and that darkness is actually revealed in our lives and our actions. And so, you know, I see the picture of the Lord. You know, Jesus is passionately, as a lawyer, pleading our case to God himself and on our behalf. And he continues to do that for you and I. He makes that intercession before God, even though we're guilty, even though we're wrong. And why does he make that case? Because he continues to point to the fact that his sentence of death gave us freedom in life, that he died so that freedom could reign in our lives. And so he's done the hard time, folks. He has paid the price that no one could. And I just think that you want to live in freedom, remember who gave it to you. Give thanks to the suffering servant, Jesus, for all that he has done. Bow your heads with me as we pray. We thank you, Father, because Isaiah has given us a great description of what it is that you had to go through, the description of who you are, and what a beautiful description of a king that we serve, and then what you had to endure, the things that you had to carry in your life, the sin, the weight of the world. There's nothing but gratitude that comes from my heart, and I pray the same comes from each one of us as well, that we would turn to you and look to you and thank you for all that you have given to us freely, and that we would cherish it, Father. I pray blessing over your children now. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you. May the Lord be gracious unto you. May the Lord turn his face toward you. And may he give you peace throughout this week. Hey, God bless you. I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Once again, thank you for joining us. And I just have a couple reminders that we are still doing Kingdom Pantry. It is is going to be something that we continue to offer. We're thankful to the Lord for this supply He has given us, and we want to honor Him in that. So just some reminders on how that works. 8:30 in the morning to noon is where we need volunteers. So anytime that you can offer, I will tell you that the hands would be greatly appreciated. And then anyone that you know that needs food, please send them our way. We have our food distribution between the hours of 10 a.m. to noon. And then we look forward to continue to do this throughout the year to come. Hey, God bless you, and we look forward to seeing you soon.